This video is for anybody that wants to overhaul their Saeco clamshell boiler. I bought a Solis 5000 espresso machine on eBay for about 75 bucks. I was always expecting the worst, something may have to be replaced, and the boiler was leaking. It was completely encrusted with limescale, as you see. And rather than having to spend the money and just replace it, what I wanted to do is to just give it a try and see if I can fix this myself. You can do this. It's really doesn't take much. It does require some tools, and they're going to have to be metric tools because this is made in Italy. And so you're going to have to use a number 10 wrench or a number 10 socket wrench as well. You're going to need to have at least some kind of a brush, a stiff brush. I use both nylon as well as brass. That's really basically it. Just to give you a quick demonstration of how this works is that when I open this up, this was completely encrusted. I mean, this makes you really, if you can, go out and buy some of these decalcifying tablets for your machine, because this thing was completely encrusted. And what happens is that these seals, which keep these two halves together, or keep the pressure from keep the pressure inside the boiler, these things just eventually rot. And I know it's kind of hard to see, but if you notice, this is a new one. This is a new seal that I bought. It's a whole sealing kit that comes from, I bought this from eBay, $11 from a company in Russia. And if you notice, I mean, just comparing the thickness, I mean, you could see that this is the old one, this is the new one, clearly. It really just, it gets rotted away after time. So let's throw this away. When I open this up, again, all along the channel where this seal sits, it was completely encrusted. What I did was, is I soaked both halves in CLR, which is a household, it's like a common descaling product that you can get pretty much in any supermarket. It costs about $5 or $6, and you dilute it with a little bit of water. So what I did was I probably has 1 part to 5 parts water of CLR. I soaked this overnight in the stuff. And then the day after, what I did was I took these brushes and I just scraped away as much scale as I possibly could. So that's basically it. When you get into the edges here, be careful. Don't use a stainless steel brush because this is aluminum. Stainless steel is going to scratch. Brass is going to scratch it maybe just a little bit, but it's not going to create these really, really big, deep grooves. You don't really want that. So, just use something if you can. If you don't have a brass brush, a good, solid nylon brush or stiff toothbrush will do the trick. Really all you got to do is to just... you put the seal on here. I would recommend that you put food safe grease, just a little bit. I mean, put a little bit of grease on your fingers and just rub it all the way around before you seal this. If you notice that it has these, there's like a little protrusion here, and there's an indentation here, so you can only put this together one way. Okay? So this is a product, I hope you guys can see this because my focus is set. So this is a product that I've used before. I have a KitchenAid blender that I use to pack the gears. The gears have to be replaced. So this is just a big old tube of food safe grease. So all you've got to do is, don't need much. Stay okay, and just have a little bit on my finger here, and I'm just creating a nice little light coating on this. Okay, and we'll and put that in. Okay. I'm also going to put on these bolts, I'm also going to put a little bit of that same food grease, because when I took these apart, this was really, those bolts were really coated with a lot of lime scale. So it's just a good idea. In fact, when I was taking off this top bolt, the head just popped right off. It was just so stuck on there. So I had to actually buy a replacement bolt. Well, sort of. This is a, at your home improvement store, this is a flange bolt. And it's metric as well. It's the same thread. This is M6 by 1 by 28 millimeters. Okay, our two halves are have been tightened. So the seal is, you can't even see it. It's just metal to metal. So it looks really good. I wanted to mention two things. There's a little hole here, and there's a hole in the back. Okay, this is the outtake. This is where the water comes out. This is where the water comes in from the pump. Inside are two O-rings that you also will get when you order from this. And again, I'm not plugging this company. It was just the cheapest one. It's 11 bucks, including shipping. So if you find something else, be my guest. But I just wanted to mention that there is an O-ring. So if you do take out this brass fitting that's normally here for your machine, just note that there's, when you're putting the hardware back, to make sure to replace that O-ring. And again, if you're doing any kind of seals, I highly recommend using food grade grease to just a little coating, just to kind of keep it from drying out and to just have a stronger stronger seal. So, all right, let's put this on the machine. By the way, this is the front of the machine, because these two points here, they're pointing up, so this is actually gets mounted onto the backboard of the machine. And this is where our two sensors are gonna be going. So this piece, I'll put this on the back right now. All right, and then afterwards, we'll get this back onto the Solis 5000. Okay, we've got our boiler assembled here, and a couple things that I wanted to point out that might be useful for someone. Excuse me. These are the brass fittings that I was talking about. There's an O-ring that is on the inside of here as well as here, right? Okay. One thing to just keep in mind is when you are unscrewing this piece, right? When you're, if you're going to be overhauling this, right? You need to take this piece off because you got to replace the O-ring, and I think it's probably just a good idea to do it. When you do take this off, don't be tempted to grab it by this end, you know, because it is, you risk having to either damage this thing to the point where it will, you know, either it'll break, because it's actually quite fragile. It's only connected here. And as you can see at this end, it's more reinforced. So if you need to twist it, if you actually do it, this is the place to do it, right? On the back, okay, this looks like one big solid piece of brass, but it isn't. This part is plastic. So when you are twisting this, make sure you do not use your fingers. Don't press against this piece, because if you press too hard, you may crack this. So make sure that you actually are using, grabbing it by the brass when you're unscrewing it and then putting it back. Okay, so just a little, I just realized that that might be useful for to mention. So, all right, we're gonna put this onto the machine right now. Okay, we've got our Saeco boiler back onto our machine here. All the connections have been put back to the way that that they were. Obviously, if you're going to be taking something apart, take plenty of pictures for reference before you take it apart, so that if you do mess up and you don't exactly know where the wires are supposed to go, you have some sort of reference point to refer to in case you mess up. So, everything is back the way that it was. A couple things that I wanted to point out. Right here, I believe this is the main thermostat for the boiler, and this is the steam thermostat. So this is for regular just water temperature, I think. But in between these sensors, right where the boiler is, they recommend that you put a little bit of this heat sink compound. It's just for, it's to make the for even distribution from the actual heat to the sensor, which makes sense. I mean, you don't want to have the sensor give you false readings because it's going to tell you that the water is hot, but it's not. So anyway, so they recommend that you you put a little bit of that in there. You don't need much, I would say, you know, like maybe, you know, honestly, like just a small dollop, you know, like something like the size of a dime, maybe. So that's it. Quick thing about these hoses. These hoses, if you take, there's a little pin here, if you take this hose out, there are two O-rings, not one, but two O-rings that are sitting right inside there. So if you do replace this, please make sure that to replace them with the two replacement O-rings. Same thing works for the output hose on the back. All right, let's put this back and see if it holds water. Okay, the boiler's been on for maybe about 20 minutes. I ran a bunch of hot water through the machine. So now there's it's filled with water and seems to be heating just fine. I don't have any issues with the temperature indicator on the machine, so everything seems to be good. If you do end up replacing this boiler, let's say for example yours is really corroded, or you know, you found something on maybe on eBay and you just need to replace it, you're going to find that there are two versions of this boiler available. One is the 120 volt version, which is what we would use in the US. This is what this is. But this is my third machine, so I've kind of repaired a few of these. But the 230 volt version will work as well. The only difference is, mechanically they work exactly the same. The only difference is that the 230 volt boiler would take about 10 minutes for it to heat up, as opposed to, let's say, 3, which is what this typically is. So if, in a pinch, if you don't mind waiting, you know, without having to, if somebody offers you something really cheap and it happens to be 230 volt, that's going to be the only difference. It works exactly the same, mounts exactly the same. There's no difference except that the resistors are different. So anyway, I hope this video was useful, and thanks for watching.